How to prove this mathematically? Again, using rotation. Rotation is a universal tool. Мы докажем это с помощью поворота, который универсальным инструментом является в нашем случае. Который вам кажется, что его объективно. Окей, I need this point. I will have take on new ones myself. Will appear by itself. And then I will take any other point and join it to the vertices. And now I will perform a rotation about what you see, 60 degree rotation, and see what happens in detail. So this is point. What will happen to point F? Where will point F arrive? Without removing точка F после этого поворота. Rotate about C by 60 degrees downward. Point F lies on the line BB1. Yes?
Yes.
So this line goes to where?
CC1.
No.
A1.
So F will now be some point on this circle.
Yes. A goes to C1 and A1 go to C.
This is where F will arrive. F prime. And this triangle CF F prime is what? CF is equal to CF prime and also to FF prime because this is an equilateral triangle, right? So then F goes to F prime, B goes to A1. So the segment BF goes here. If I add these three segments, the distances from F to the vertices, I get AF plus CF plus BF is equal to AF plus FF prime plus F prime A prime. And this is what?
A prime.
Yes. So we see that the sum of the distances from F to the vertices is just equal to our segment AA prime, but also BB1, A prime, I'm sorry, not prime.
AA1.
AA1, of course, to be honest. Yes, and I must, I'm sorry, one here and over there. So, each of these three segments is equal to the sum of the distances from F to the vertices. This will be true only if points F and F prime are on this segment. But if F somehow is out, is on the extension like A, A1, and F here, then I cannot say that this segment is equal to this one. So it won't work. This is why we need this condition. We need the lines to meet inside the triangle. Then it will work. Now what about another point? So for the point F, we see that the three distances give one segment. If I take a point X and do the same, again rotate, I will have a point X prime, the image, and BX goes to A1 X prime. B goes here, X goes here. So this segment is equal to this one. So in this case, we see that the sum of the three segments is equal to the length of this polyline. Сумма трех расстояний в данном случае равна длине вот этой области. So, you remember the word прямление, I thought, прямление. When we have a sum of the segments and make one line of one. This is what we do here, using rotation. But, the shortest distance between two points is the length of the segment. So, this length will be shorter than the sum of these three segments. And we have proof of this. A very strict proof would need a very rigorous to make it. Well, more rigorous. We must talk more about this condition. So, and prove that indeed, if all the angles are less than 120 degrees, not greater than 120 degrees, then the points, the segments will meet inside the triangle, and F prime, F and F prime will be on this segment, so we can add three segments to make one, to obtain one. This is not a very pleasant thing to prove, but I don't want to do it, so we will leave it as it is. There are also more proofs of this fact, but for us, this one is the best. As a bonus, you know the bonus in the game. So as a bonus, we get another proof that the three red segments meet at the same point. Because in this proof, I didn't use this third segment, yes? I proved that if I take two segments and their intersection point, then it will satisfy this inequality. Okay. So in the same way, I can say that if I take these two segments, for example, take this point, F1, it will also satisfy this problem. So F and F1 are both satisfied, but I have proved here if x, so when this polyline is the length, its length is equal to the segment. When these points are on the segment, x is on the segment. So if point F1 is not on this segment, then the sum of the distances must be greater than this, that we pointed. So we see that F1 must be on the segment, which means that the three segments meet at the same point. Okay. And now one more addition to this figure. So let's draw circles. Circles of this regular triangle. Who remembers what the circumcircle?
Addition.
So we will draw circles. So circles of this triangle. And we see that the circumcircle also meet at F. This is, if you know the angle, the inscribed angle theorem, you would like getting one piece of nuclear, you have to do it according to the final function. Do you know this theorem?
Yes.
So, for example, let's take AB1CF. This angle is 60 degrees, and this angle is 120 degrees. The sum is 180, so the points are on the same circle. And this is this circle. are connected with the second name in the title of this Torice. Do you know, have you heard anything about Torice? Why it is famous?
He invented the barometer.
Yes, yes. He invented the barometer. Поворачиваем. it will be what? Some favorite things for Holly. Holly likes these things very much.
Perpendicular,
yes. It will be perpendicular to the side, because this two sides will be also perpendicular. Okay? And we will have the point A, the orthocenter. So we see that many interesting points like centroid, medians, orthocenter, the intersection of the altitudes, Fermat point, and well, some other points also. They all can be described in this way. Now it is interesting. If I draw the locus of this point, геометрическое место вот этих точек пересечения, что это такое будет? So, I will tell you half of its name, and this will be your homework. So, well, you know this point, the intersection point, the locus. There was a geometer called Hipper, and this is he invented here and found this locus. But the Hipper, what? This is your own task to insert the name, and you can do it using masking. So you will take your computer, you will take the program, you will construct this point, and then move. Also, you can try to prove that that these blue lines will always confirm for any angle. This can be done by, like we did for Fermat. But you will need actually the formula.